Hello students, welcome back to Digital Learning DCE. Myself Dr. Manjula S, working as Assistant Professor of Botany in Government First Grade College, Ramanagara. In this session, let us study about lichens reproduction, their ecological and economic importance. Last session, we studied about general account of lichen and their structures. What are these lichens? Lichens are small group of curious plants made up of two living entities like algae and fungi, which are complex in nature, and the algal component is referred as phycobion and fungal component is referred as mycobion. And these lichens are variously classified into different types based on their type of fungal component. They are categorized into three types like ascolichen, basidiolichen and lichen imperfecti. Based on the substratum on which they grow, they are categorized into saxicolous lichen, trichocolous lichen, corticolous lichen, folicolous lichen and mercicolous lichen. Based on their external morphology, lichens are categorized into crustose lichen, foliose lichen and fruticose lichen. Likewise, based on their internal structures, lichens are divided into two types, homomerous lichen and heteromerous lichen. So, in today's session, let us study about reproduction of lichen and their ecological and economic importance. Let me begin with the reproduction. Lichens reproduce by three important methods like vegetative, asexual and sexual means. Let us study one by one in detail. Lichens reproduce vegetatively by fragmentation, soridia and acidia formation. The fragmentation is accompanied by aging of lichen thallus and also by means of accidental method. So in case of aging of lichen thallus, the cells present in the lichen thalli is going to become inactive. Some of the cells during that time, they break into smaller pieces called fragments. These fragments, by their apical growth, develops into new individual lichen thalli. In second case, that is by means of accidentally, when there is a mechanical injury to the lichen thalli, due to this injury, the segment of the thalli gets separated, and this separated piece is referred as fragment. This fragment, by the apical growth, develops into new lichen thalli. Then vegetative reproduction is also takes place by two important propagules like soridia and decidia. Last session we studied about these specialized structures called soridia and decidia, which are usually developed on the surface of the lichen thalli. The soridia and decidia are reproductive propagules which, on detachment from the lichen thalli, they develops into new individual lichen thalli. So in this picture, we can observe the soridia formation. The soridia are nothing but an algal cell covered by a filament of fungal hyphae. On the upper surface of the lichen thalli, these soridia are formed in large numbers. When they are formed in a large number, a pressure is created in the upper surface so that the upper cortical zone will break open and releases a mass of grayish green color spores called soridia. Soridia, when the wind blows, they carried away to the different places. When they fall on the suitable substratum, each soridia develops into new individual lichen thalli. Coming to the second propagule, vegetative propagule observed in case of lichen reproduction is Isidia. Isidia are small finger-like, wattle-like structure which are developed on the upper surface of the lichen thalli, which are provided with a small constriction on their lower side. Due to the presence of this constriction, it is easy to detach this Isidia from the mother lichen thalli. So, when this Isidia generally consists of number of algal cells covered by fungal hyphae. So, when they detached from the mother lichen thalli, they carried away by wind, when they fall on the suitable substratum, these Soridia are developed into new lichen thalli. So the difference between Soridia and Soridia is that in case of Soridia, there is no cortical layer. It is only consists of a single algal cell surrounded by a filament of fungal hyphae. Whereas in case of Soridia, it consists of more than 2 or 3 or around 10 algal cells along with some of fungal hyphae, and they are mainly covered by cortical layer of the main lichen thalli. So this is a major difference between Soridia and Soridia. Both Soridia and Soridia are act as vegetative propagules which bring about reproduction in case of lichens. Coming to asexual reproduction in case of lichens. As we all know, lichen is made up of two important components. Algal component called phycobiont and fungal component is called mycobiont. In the algal component, if it is a green alga, belongs to chlorophyceae, that green alga multiplies asexually by producing two important type of spores called aplanospores and zoospores. If it is a blue-green alga, if the phycobiont component is a blue-green alga, belongs to cyanophyceae, then it multiplies by three different types of spores like armogonia, echinace and heterocyst. So here we can observe the aplanospores and zoospores in case of green alga, where aplanospores are thin-walled spores, non-motile spores, which are produced inside a sporangium, and separation and liberation from the sporangium, these aplanospores, when come in contact with suitable fungal hyphae, develops into new lichen thalli. Whereas in case of blue-green alga, in case of green algae only, if it is a zoospore formation, this zoospores are motile spores which are provided with flagella. Since there are two flagella, their to and fro movements helps in motility. So zoospores, after liberate from the zoosporangium, they swim in a thin film of water, and when they come in contact with a suitable fungal hyphae, they develops into new lichen thalli. Whereas in case of blue-green algae, I told it is usually filamentous form of algae like Nostoc or Anabina. Asexually, this blue-green algal component reproduced by Armogonia, Echinace and Heterocyst. Armogonia are chain of algal cells. A small filament which is made up of chain of cells is referred as Armogonia. They usually formed at the point of heterocyst. Heterocysts are specialized cells which are provided with polar nodules. In case of terminal heterocyst, there is only one polar nodule, whereas in case of intercalary heterocyst, two polar nodules are present. Usually these Armogonia are formed at the region of heterocyst so that they can easily break, and the breaked filaments, when they come in contact with the fungal hyphae, it can develop into new individual lichen thalli. So like that, echinoids are thick-walled resting spores. Echinoids are another type of asexual spores which are observed in case of blue-green algae of lichen thallus, where they are the thick-walled resting spores. They are provided with reserved food materials. They are going to form during unfavorable environmental conditions. So on return of favorable environmental conditions, this echinoid break open. Till the favorable environmental conditions comes, it is dormant in nature. On return of favorable condition, these echinoids break open their thick wall, and the content, again by the means of cell division, develops a filament of algal cell, which when come in contact with a hyphae, fungal hyphae, develops into new lichen thalli. So this is about the phycobiont component of lichen thalli. Coming to the mycobiont component, that is fungal component of lichen thalli, a few lichens hyphae breaks up into a small segments called edia. Edia is nothing but the hyphae, which is made up of the 2 to 3 cells of Eiffel cells, 2 to 3 Eiffel cells. This breaks in a chain, that is called edia. This edia germinate into new fungal hyphae, which produces a lichen thalli when comes in contact with suitable alkyl cell. So in many lichen thalli, the fungal partner also produces large number of small asexual spores called pycnospores or pycnidia, which are going to be formed inside a small flash shaped structure called pycnia. This pycnospores are produced inside a small cup shaped structure or flash shaped structure called pycnia. So it is good, the pycnia or pycnospores are formed in chains. When they cut off ear, they releases into the cavity of the pycnidium, and this pycnidium, which is a flash shaped structure, which is going to be a small opening called osteole. Through this osteole, this asexual spores, pycnia or pycnospores, is going to come out to the external environment. When they come in contact with the suitable hyphae, it develops into new lichen thalli. So these are the different asexual spores observed in case of lichen thalli. Coming to sexual reproduction in case of ascolichens. We already studied in the last session that ascolichens are group of lichens where the phycobiont component or the fungal component belongs to class Ascomycetes. So in case of ascolichen or any lichen, the fungal component of lichen thalli is mainly responsible to bring about the sexual reproduction. In case of ascolichen, the male reproductive organ, male sex reproductive organ, is referred as spermogonium, which is a flask shaped structure. Spermogonium is a flask shaped structure which is filled with two types of hyphae, the sterile hyphae referred as spermophyses and fertile hyphae. So the fertile hyphae is going to form, it is going to cut down number of minute, small, rounded male cells called spermatia. This spermatia are non-motile in nature and they are surrounded by a thin cell wall around them, and they set free into the cavity of spermogonium, which is filled with mucilaginous substances. Through this mucilaginous slimy mass, this spermatia comes out from the lichen thalli through a small opening called osteole. So spermogonium is a male sex organ which is going to produce the male cells called spermatia. Spermatia are non-motile cells which are filled inside the cavity of spermogonium, and they oozes out in a thin film of mucilaginous mass through an osteole. Coming to the female sex organ in case of lichen, ascolichen, is called as carpogonium. Carpogonium is a special cellular filament which consists of lower coiled portion. The carpogonium, which is a female sex organ of lichens, ascolichens, is made up of it two parts. The lower coiled portion is referred as carpogonium or ascogonium, which is multicellular in nature. It is either uninucleate or multinucleate, whereas the upper straight portion, the upper straight portion of carpogonium, is referred as trichogyne. Trichogyne is also multicellular in nature. It is an elongated structure. On its tip, it bears a elongated cell covered by a gelatinous wall. So this is referred as trichogyne. At the time of fertilization in ascolichen, the spermatia, which are male cells released from spermogonium, come in contact with the gelatinous wall of trichogyne. The trichogyne is referred as a female part, female cell. So when spermatia come in contact with the trichogyne, The wall between the two dissolves and the content of spermatia discharge into the trichogyne. The trichogyne is made up of with the septa. It is multicellular in nature, whose cross walls are provided with small pores called septal pores. Through the septal pores, the content of the spermatia move and reaches the ascogonium, which is below the female sex organ. So the male nucleus of spermatia passes down the carpogonium through septal pore and fuses with the female nuclei, which is reside in the ascogonium region. So that after the fusion, the numerous septate ascogenous hyphae are going to develop from the fertilized ascogonium. So the binucleate cells of this ascogenous hyphae develops into number of ascus mother cells referred as asci, inside which 8 oval-shaped ascospores are going to be formed as a result of sexual reproduction. So here we can observe the spermatia or male nuclei, when it reaches the trichogyne, from the trichogyne, the septal pore, it come down to reach the ascogonium, where in the ascogonium the female nuclei resides. So fertilization between the two takes place, ascogonium and spermatia takes place, results in diploid dikaryotic condition, from which a number of hyphae, ascogenous hyphae, are going to be formed. Out of ascogenous hyphae, some are sterile, some are fertile. The sterile hyphae are referred as paraphysis, whereas fertile hyphae going to bear a number of asci under tip. Asci in turn contain 8 ascospores, which are oval shaped. In case of ascolichen, sexual reproduction results in the formation of two types of fruiting bodies, like apothecium and peritheceum. So, where the asci, which are nothing but the fertile hyphae, ascus mother cells, are enveloped by the sterile hyphae. In this diagram we can observe, this is a asci or ascus, ascus on either side covered by the sterile hyphae. This sterile hyphae are referred as paraphysis. So this the two nuclei within the ascus, one from male, another from female, they are going to fuse to form a diploid nucleus. This diploid nucleus undergo meiotic division first, followed by one mitotic division, results in the formation of 8 ascospores. So the ascospores, on liberation, they germinate to produce a hypha. This hypha, when come in contact with algal cell, it develops into new lichen thalli. So in this diagram we can observe the fruiting body of ascolichen, which are nothing but apothecium. Apothecium are small cup-like structure which are developed on the surface of the lichen thalli. So in a vertical section, the apothecium, this is the extended part of the lichen thalli. On its margin, it is going to bear a thin layer called hymenum or subhymenum, from which the fertile and sterile hyphae are going to be developed. So the sterile hyphae are referred as paraphysis, whereas fertile hyphae are referred as asci. Asci inside undergo meiotic division to form 8 haploid ascospores. Ascospores are oval in shape, uninucleate, and they are provided with bit of protoplasm. When the pressure is created inside the asci or ascus, so it releases the ascospore into external environment. When this ascospore come in contact, germinate to form hyphae, when this hyphae come in contact with algal cell, it develops into new lichen thalli. Coming to the second type of fruiting body produced in ascolichen is called as peritheceum. The peritheceum is much smaller in size compared to apothecium, and it appears as a dot-like structure on the surface of the lichen thalli. If you take a section, in vertical section, the peritheceum is seen as a flask-shaped structure. While the apothecium is a cup-shaped structure, the peritheceum is a flask-shaped structure. It is covered by a thick dark colored wall around it, whose cavity is lined with number of acini. Again, compared to the apothecium, the paraphysals in case of peritheceum are less in number, or sometimes they are absent at all. So this peritheceum opens at the surface through a small pore called osteole. Through this osteole, the ascus releases the ascospores into external environment. When the ascospore releases out, they germinate to produce hyphae. Hyphae, when come in contact with the algal cells, they are going to develop new lichen thalli. So this is about the sexual reproduction observed in case of ascolichen, where as a result of fertilization, two fruiting bodies are going to be formed. One is called apothecium, another one is called peritheceum. Apothecium is a cup-shaped structure, whereas the peritheceum is a flask-shaped structure. But finally, both of them are going to bear 8 ascospores. Ascospores releases, and when they germinate to form hyphae, hyphae when come in contact with the algal cell produces a lichen thalli. Coming to sexual reproduction in case of basidiolichen. Basidiolichens are group of lichen where the mycobiont component belongs to basidiomycetes. So here sexual reproduction in basidiolichen is same as basidiomycetes, where basidiolichens reproduce by another type of spores called basidiospores, which are produced inside a special structure called basidia or basidium, which are produced on lower surface of the lichen thalli. They are going to bear the subhymenum layer and the basidia arranged in the form of palisade-like cells on the lowermost face of each subhymenum. So each basidium, which are produced on the lower surface of the lichen thalli, bears 4 basidiospores. These 4 basidiospores are usually develops on a special bottle-shaped structure called stigmata. So in case of basidiolichen, on the lower surface, a cup-like structure is there, that is called as a basidium. Basidium on its strip, it is going to produce a bottle-shaped structure called stigmata. Each stigmata cut down 4 basidiospores. Basidiospores on detachment from the stigmata, they releases out and they germinate to produce fungal hyphae, which when come in contact with the algal cell develops into new lichen thalli. So this is about the sexual reproduction observed in case of basidiolichen. So now let us study about some ecological and economic importance of lichens. Lichens are of ecological value because of the following points, like they are the pioneer of rock vegetation, they accumulate radioactive substances, they act as biological pollution indicator, they also affect atmospheric nitrogen. Let us study the ecological importance of lichen one by one in detail. First one, lichens are pioneer of rock vegetation. Pioneer means it is the first community to be established on the rock. So when they grow on the rock, lichen have the capacity to grow within a minimum amount of water and less humus. So they are able to grow on a barren rock, and as a result of their growth, they are going to release some acids called lichenic acid. That acid going to disintegrate the rock particles, results in weathering and forms soil. So when the soil is formed on the rock surface, this old lichen thalli, when it becomes dead, it adds its humus to the soil already formed by means of weathering, so that the soil along with the death of a lichen thalli, it will become much humus, so that it is suitable for the growth of certain mosses. Hence lichen act as a pioneer of rock vegetation and brings about succession, xeric succession on rocks. Second point of ecological importance include accumulation of radioactive substances. Atomic Research Center reported that certain lichen thalli can absorb radioactive substances like strontium and cesium. Thus, they purify the atmosphere from radioactive substances. Coming to third one, that is biological pollution indicators. Lichens are very sensitive to pollutants like sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide present in the air. Means they won't grow in the smoky polluted atmosphere. Hence, lichens act as indicators of air pollution. So, where the lichens are abundant in number, that environment is free from pollution. That indicates that the environment is free from air pollutants. Then coming to fixation of atmospheric nitrogen. Due to their association with algae, particularly blue-green algae, lichens are capable of converting nitrogen from the air into nitrate. This conversion of nitrogen impacts the ecosystem because when it is heavily rains, nitrates are leached from the lichen's thalli and it is used by the soil-based plants. These are of some ecological importance of lichen. Coming to economic importance of lichen. In the economic importance of lichen, we can study it under two headings. One is useful aspects and another one is harmful aspects of lichen. Let us study the uses of lichen as economic importance. First one is lichens are used as food and fodder. Certain species of lichens are valuable sources of food and fodder for caterpillars, number of snails, termites and animals. Example, Cladonia rangiferina is a type of lichen which is a favorite food of reindeer. So lichens are used as fodder for animals, caterpillars, snails, termites, etc. A few species of lichens are also used as food by human beings. Example, Parmelia and Cetraria. In France, some species are used for making delicious chocolates and pastries. In Japan, Endocarpon miniatum is used as a vegetable. Whereas in India, in some places, it is called by the name rock flower, stone flower. So it is used as a spices in preparation of some spicy foods. So in this picture, we can observe lichen used as a spice, and lichens are food for birds, lichen food for animal like reindeer. So coming to the second use, that is industrial uses of lichen. Some lichens like Cetraria and Labaria are used as tanning agents in leather industry. Lichens have been used for centuries as dye in coloring fabrics and paints. Example, Orchil, it is used to dye woolens in textile industry. Orchil is a dye which is extracted from lichen. It is used to dye the woolens in textile industry. Likewise, litmus is another important dye used in chemical laboratories as an acid-base indicator which is obtained from the species of Rosella. Coming to uses of lichen as medicines. In earlier days, few species of lichens have been used to cure jaundice, fevers, diarrhea, hydrophobia and various skin diseases. So examples of such lichen which are having medicinal value are as follows: Peltigida, Cetraria, Parmelia and Laboria. Recently, a yellow substance obtained from Usnea and Cladonia is used as a broad spectrum antibiotic which is useful in treatment of various skin infections. A mucilaginous substance obtained from Cetraria islandica, it is used as a laxative. Laxative means it is a substance which is going to induce the motion. So lichens are having laxative property. Next example as a medicine use is they are important ingredients of many antiseptic creams as they have tumor inhibiting capacity and also spasmolytic properties. Spasmolytic properties means the drugs which are used to reduce muscle contraction. So like this, lichens have various medicinal applications. So these are some ointments which are used as antiseptics, and this is the drugs, anti-tumor drugs extracted from lichens. Then coming to some of the lichens, due to their sweet scented thalli used in manufacture of dhoop, havan samagris and other perfumeries. Some species of Evernia and Ramalina are source of essential oils. They are going to produce certain essential oils which are used in the manufacture of cosmetic soaps and perfumeries. So these are beneficial aspects of lichens. Coming to harmful aspects or harmful activities of lichen, several lichens are harmful as they cause considerable loss due to etching of glass surface and marble stones. Likewise, lichens, due to production of lichenic acid, they are going to reduce the market value of sandalwood by causing damage. Some lichens such as Letharia ulpine, which is commonly called as wolf moss, they are poisonous in nature. So a fruticose lichen called Usnea, it grows very abundantly on forest trees. During odd season, they become dry and they are highly inflammable. They are easy to catch the fire, hence easily catches the fire and cause forest fire, so that it destroys the whole forest. Some lichens also destroy colonies of mosses by direct parasitic attack. So with this economic values of lichen, I'm going to sum up this session by saying this following points. Like, lichens reproduce vegetatively by fragmentation, soridia and isidia formation, where in case of fragmentation, the separated piece is referred as a fragment, which is formed due to mechanical injury. It has the capacity to develop into new lichen thalli, whereas soridia and isidia are specialized structures formed on the surface of the lichen thalli, which on detachment, when they fall on the suitable substratum, they are going to produce new lichen thalli. Lichens reproduce asexually by spore formation, whereas in case of the algal component of lichen thalli, reproduce asexually by asexual spores called aplanospores, which are thin-walled non-motile spores, zoospores. They are motile spores produced inside the zoosporangium. And the cyanobacterial part of lichen thalli reproduce through armogonia, and fungal component of lichens reproduce through edia formation, and also by special type of small spores called pycnidiospores. In case of ascolichens, they reproduce sexually by forming a special type of rooting bodies called apothecia and perithecia, which finally going to form oval shaped 8 ascospores. These ascospores germinate into hyphae. When they come in contact with a algal cell, they are going to produce new thalli. Whereas in case of basidiolichens, they are going to produce the special type of spores called basidiospores on a bottle shaped structure called stigmata, which are formed on basidium. Lichens are ecologically important since they are biological indicators of air pollution. They are the indicators of air pollution, pioneers of rock vegetation, and hence bring about the xeric succession in plant community. They are involved in soil formation, nitrogen fixation, and they also observe radioactive substances present in the atmosphere. Lichens are also economically important as food, fodder, medicine, tanning industry, in dyeing industry, perfumeries, and also in cosmetic industries. Some lichens are of harmful as they damage glass, marble, sandalwood, and they also cause forest fire. With this, I am going to conclude the present session. For more details about the current topic, you can refer the following references. Thank you.